Yeah, now it would make sense if I actually turned the camera on before trying to hit the record button. Anyway, good morning. Well, yeah, close enough. I think I've been awake a couple of hours, roughly, thereabouts. I'm not sure. I've done a bit more sorting of the screws, but I'm definitely not going to be short of a screw, am I? Considering I've got another big tub like that full in my cupboard. And I'm definitely not going to be short of a few tacks, am I? That is just what that's full of, tacks. These various sizes. Most are just that size. My washers, wall plugs in here temporarily. Don't know if I'll ever use them, but you never know. If I don't, I'm sure I'll know someone that will want some. Definitely not short of a hexagon key. You know, that reminds me, I found another four when I was sorting out some bags. Definitely not short of a hexagon key. I've just got that tub to go through. I think I'm going to need at least one more tub. One more turb. I don't think I've got one more turb. I've got some old margarine tubs I could wash up, I suppose. Tell it's a Wednesday because the car park's quiet. Right. Oh yeah, I've got the lock off that. It's quite a deceptive lock, and this is why I don't like cable locks. Even one this thick took me less than 60 seconds to cut through it with that hacksaw. And do you know why? Because if you look at that end, it's a very thin cable. It looks thick when you look at this. It actually looks like a thick old bit of cable, but it's an illusion. It's mostly that PVC stuff with a thin piece of cable going through it. And it's only a steel cable. It's not hardened or anything, so hacksaws go straight through them. Yeah, they're a good enough deterrent, you know, for during the day in busy places. Because I think it would look a bit suspicious if someone was standing there in broad daylight with a hacksaw. but I certainly wouldn't use a cable lock to lock it somewhere overnight. Not even in my own garage or anything. A reflector pointing at the wheel isn't a lot of good. Right then. Take this stupid bloody mud guard off. Busted anyway, look. Normally I'd keep mud guards, but this one's a bit chewed and so that's another one for the bin. I'll keep the bracket and the bolt if I can get it out. Yep. Keep that bolt. I'll take that bracket off and keep it, and I'll drop the seat down. Not sure what I'm going to do with this one yet. Brakes seem to work. And I'm going to go downstairs later and change the brake blocks on my Rally Max. I don't even know what Rally this is. There's no stickers. It's just a Rally. Ooh. I like those low brackets. Because I like these bits. I usually change the type of bracket on here, but reuse these pieces because they go around pretty much any size tube or bar on a bicycle, so they're quite a universal bracket. That's why I like to keep those. And we don't have a rear reflector, I'll have to change that. Easy peasy. Oh, that's where my other hacksaw went. My blade's getting blunt in that one though. I've got a spare one somewhere. Downstairs, I think. I don't think the gears work on it. Have I got a Phillips or something? Is that a Phillips? That's a Phillips. Let's see if we can get this off out of the way. I'll get the bloody screwdriver on the end of the screw. Alright. Is that loose enough? Yep. Oh, there goes a bit of rubber. Right. Now it's a quick release seat. But the question is, has it seized into the frame? Quite possibly. It might be frozen. And I've got that completely freed. I can't do it one-handed anyway. I'll just put you there for the moment. Oh dear. The seat itself moves. The seat post itself doesn't. Wheel bearings need to be tightened. I'm sure with a bit of squirty of this, let's see if I can get any out of this here. That's nice and loosey-goosey. I'm going to take the quick release off. I did have a large slot screw. Ah, there it is. Large flathead screwdriver. Bollocks. I don't know what I dropped that. Why does it always drop it? It's because I took my eyes off it. That's right. I've got a straight handlebar downstairs. I can throw in this as well. I'll use up what's in this can and then I'll go and get fresh. I think I've changed my mind on the master system. I'm just going to open that up. Open that up a bit. And I'm just going to spray it. Let that soak for the rest of the day. Yeah, and I can see that's actually running down inside there. It's a steel frame and a steel seat post, so this should be enough to free it off. Well, it's definitely running down inside there. I can't see it running down the frame, which is a good thing. Sometimes there's such a tight seal around there that it runs down the frame more than anything. So I'm just going to... I want to save a little bit of this just to get those handlebar grips off. But like I said, I need a fresh can of this anyway because this is nearly out. But it's a fiver for a can, but it's worth it. Especially the one with the built-in straw. Because you can't lose the straw. I think that'll do for now. That should free it up if I crank the seat down tightly. I've got my big pipe wrench. Is my big pipe wrench up here or is it downstairs? I think it's still up here somewhere. I need to have a clean up. Some of this stuff. Actually, if I have a clean up in the bedroom, I can chuck some of it in there. Pardon me. A bag of cables can go back in the cupboard outside. Oh, damn, full of wind. If I get some room in here, I've got to get some Lego videos done for that channel. Right. I'm just debating whether it disappeared downstairs or not. It's on there quite tight. Actually I will, and I'll try and sort the brakes out on my Rally Max. The front one squeaks like hell and it's driving me up the wall. Which is bad, because the front brake works better than the rear brake, but I don't like to hit it because, like I said, it squeaks like hell. And it's embarrassing when you're trying to stop. And you just, you know, you hit your brakes and just get this high-pitched squeal come from them. So I'm going to try some different brake blocks. I might take a lump of steel wool down with me as well and just rub it around the rims. I'm just checking Facebook, make sure no one's messaged me or anything. Check my emails before I go down. I've put that still of a mountain bike, the Mountain Ridge, up on eBay. Well, eBay listing is confirmed. Oh, I thank you. Nope, no emails. Alright. On that note, I'm going downstairs. I'm back. I've just been in Black Records and I've got a free sweetie, so I'm sucking on one of them. Anyway, changed the brake blocks on the Rally Max. My 1990s mountain bike, and I know that it's a 1990s, mid to late 90s, because my cousin had one brand new round about that time. Also remembered to bring that up, and it does fit. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to give this bracket a lick of paint and clean it up. Then I can bolt that on and bolt the chain on, and it's two more jobs done. Well, if the chain's long enough. But I has a bag. What do I have in the bag? Well, I think you know, because I couldn't actually resist it. Two games. The console itself. And the necessary cables. Well, I had to, go for a little test ride, make sure the brakes were working, so I kind of sort of swung round by Black Records. The question is, how and where am I going to set this up? May actually have to move that out of the way, I think. I'm going to get this corner cleared. To move it, I'll just take the drawers out. Because I'm going to have to move the TV. So I think I may have to put that on a SCART input. And I think I may put these on friggin' eBay. Because I ain't going to... Well, actually, I'll keep one for myself and I'll put the other two on eBay. That one's open. That one's still sealed. That one's still sealed. So I can actually set them as new sealed. I'll do a bit of research and see if I can see what sort of prices they are on there and set mine perhaps a little bit cheaper. Or the same price, one or the other. Right. So it's my afternoon booked. I'll give that a little longer to soak. I've got a handlebar up here to swap. I am now completely skint apart from £1 something in my bank account and what I've got in my pocket. That. But like I said, I've got food, I'm not going to starve. Pardon me. Plus, I've got my pot changed there if I really did get brassic. What have we got here anyway? One British pound. Let's teach your currency, shall we? Into 50 pence piece. So two of those makes up £1. And that's a £1 coin. So I've got £3. £4. And despite my French friend taking I don't know how many trips here, he still can't fathom British currency. So we've got 4, 5, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 5 20 pence pieces make up a pound. Need a 10 pence piece, really. Get rid of the 5p, so I've actually got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pounds and 10 pence. and change. Actually, speaking of change, when I was sorting through all that crap, I found a bunch of these coins as well. I think these are from Cyprus. That one is a very old British 5p. It's no longer legal tender. Because the new one is probably about half the size of that. Then we've got all these. Now, all I can see on them is the number 10. And on the other side, it's got... can't actually quite read it. Cyprus. I don't know. Hard to read some of these. What's that one? Cyprus something of... no, it actually looks like it's written in Latin or something. I don't bloody know. That's another 10. Whatever it is. That's got the value of 20 written on it. Whatever it is. I need to get my magnifying glass out, I think, so I can read them. What's that one? That's another 10. I don't know, but those two are the same. That's another 10. That's another 10. Not a fucking clue. But they're interesting. Probably interesting to me because they're not British and, you know, 32 years in Britain, my life. You sort of get used to your own currency and it just doesn't seem interesting, does it? Oh. Nom 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 nom. Bloody sweet. Right. So I think for the rest of the afternoon, I need to hope that bike will sell. Mind you, the things I need to get through, that lot on there is enough. But I'm just gonna check my emails again. It's a 30-day listing, so it may take a while to shift if it sells on eBay. I'm actually going to message someone on Facebook shortly as well, see if her other half is interested. Oh yeah, I might put that on for a little while as well. North Norfolk Radio. As it's the... not the time tunnel, what do they call it? Not guess the year, something like that. Or is it time tunnel? I can't remember. I play 8 songs from a specific year and give you clues and you're supposed to guess it. Obviously, because it's music, I can't do that on camera because of YouTube. But anyway, I'm going to turn the camera off. Go have a tidy up in the bedroom. I've got to have a tidy up in the bedroom for 2 reasons now. To set up the master system and to stack some of these boxes in there. So, back later. Well, I haven't done much since I last put the camera on. In fact, I've done absolutely fuck all. But I have been out on my bike. Because as some of you may know, I've got an interest in the fire service. Not in being a firefighter, because of my own illnesses and disabilities. I wouldn't get in anyway, I doubt. Because you need good communication and, I'm not very good at team communication, so yeah. Thanks to my mental disability, you know, I have the Asperger syndrome. I could do everything else fine, it's just social interactivity, you know, and working in a team. I suck. Anyway, I just like watching the firefighters in action, you know. And no, I've never deliberately gone and done something to get them out. I'm not that fucking stupid. I don't agree with... In fact, one of the things that really pissed me off is prank calling the fire service. I did lots of, you know, I got into mischief when I was a kid, like any kid would. But the one thing I never did was prank calling emergency services. Anyway, but our fire engine got a call out, and I thought, well, I'm not doing much, I'll hop on the bike and see if I can find it, because I went on their live instant feed and it said North Walsham as the location. So I thought, eh, I'll see if I can find it, and it wasn't hard. On the count of, it seems our fire engine has a bit of a water leak. So all I did was follow the water trail. It was just this faint water line that went all the way around town to where it was. So it's not exactly hard when it leaves you a good clue like that. But it was a false alarm anyway. Reports of a house fire, but it was a false alarm, cooking fumes. Apparently 3 fire engines were called, but only ours was there, so I presume the other 2 were stood down. In fact, they would have been if they weren't there. They would have been stood down. It's like playing hide and seek with a fire engine, isn't it? It goes out on a shout and hides up in town and I go find it. Except it leaves a clue. it's not a major water leak, you know, nothing. I don't think that would really be anything to worry about. I think it could be the water level on the back that may have sprung a leak. I mean, it is a 2004 appliance, which would make that over 10 years old. 12 years old, roughly. Depending when it was registered in 2004. So yeah, we'll say 12 years old, so... Bloody hell, was it really that long ago that we got the new Scanias? Hell. Although I don't think we actually got one in North Walsham until around about 2006. Because I know they started buying in the Scanias around the 2000... Well, about that age. That would have been one of the first ones they bought. So no doubt that got handed down from another station. I could actually confirm it because I know firefighters at work on our crew anyway, so... If it really bugged me, I could easily message them and ask them. But I'm pretty certain we didn't get a brand new one. Or did we? I know ours went in for repairs. One of my fellow firefighter buffs has just liked my post on Facebook. I put, you know you're a fire service geek when you can follow a fire engine around town on your push bike just by following the water trail it left behind. It's true, that's why I did. I was bored, and besides, the exercise did me good. But that's why I've got my top off, because I'm hot. And I can't find my little USB fan, it's disappeared. Otherwise I'd have set that on the desk. Right, now what I was going to do originally is go into that bedroom and just clear that corner. There isn't actually a lot there, to be honest. It'll only take me about 5 minutes, so I'm going to do that, and I'll report back later. Right, I've got it in place. It's all wired up, it is working. But because both of these are RF connectors, you only get one RF connector on a television. So what I've done, I found this splitter, and it's got a switch on it. You just slide it between the two. That's now on the Mega Drive. If I put it that way, that's on the Master System. That's going through the SCART socket on the back, the PlayStation one. And that is actually super glued to that, so it might be a bit of a bitch to get off if I have to take it off. But I just wanted it somewhere. I could have plugged it straight in the back of the TV, but yeah, how would I actually get there to switch it over? Which is why I've done it that way. So I've got this one that goes out to the TV, and one of those little sticky back clips just to keep the cable looking a bit tidy. This does seem to have a bit of a dicky power port on the console itself, but I think it's just loose solder joints, which is, I could fix that, I could put a new one on if I have to. But yeah, it does work, and I will do a separate video on it all running at some point. I've done another bodge repair on the top of that, because I did use sticky tape originally, but it just came unstuck. But I've actually done it both sides this time, and I've left a gap there deliberately because I want to get under there at some point and install a second power outlet, which I might actually put along further along here actually, because I was running out of sockets. I don't need that many more up this end. Actually, I think if I bought a six-way and just put an extra socket up this end, I'd probably have enough outlets up this far end, possibly. Yeah. I've got four ways. I could get away with a four way. Another four way, you know, I could cut the power lead down. I might do that actually, it'd be just as easy. If I've got to run another socket over to here anyway. Got a couple four ways I can use. I've actually got one in the box under there. It's only got half the plug with it, so but if I'm going to cut the lead down, it doesn't matter. Got plenty of plugs. I've put all my bits and bobs in a bigger tub, and I have got places to put them. My cupboard underneath the kitchen sink is pretty much empty, so I'm going to stuff some gear in there out of the way. So the last thing I've got left to sort, there's that tub in the hallway there, and just this little bit of shit in here. I've got a tub full of dowels, and I've got a tub full of bits underneath. I've got to find a tub for those, and that lot down there. I think I'm going to chuck the nails. Actually, I might put the nails and whatnot under the, in the cupboard under the sink. Well, I've found some more hexagon keys. I must have found about 30 of the fucking things in this lot. Look at it. All these shiny ones on top are what I've actually pulled out. I pulled out a couple from there earlier. They were laying in the top. Got no idea. Okay, don't want that. I might do that later. I need to clear some floor space. And I've got a little slither of metal or something in my finger and I can't get it out. But I can feel it every time I brush my finger in a certain direction. It's that way. Every time I do that, I can feel it. Oh well, it'll come out. It'll come out eventually. I might get a few bits up on eBay as well later tonight. And I've got to do my Lego videos, so I'll get something up on the Lego channel. And I've decided what I'm going to do with this light. It's going to be a decorative light. What I'm going to do, I haven't decided where I'm going to put it yet. But, it's got to go that way up. I could stick it up there, just as a decorative lamp up the corner with a, I don't know, a coloured light bulb or something in it. And the cable can just run down the wall to the sockets. Or, I was going to do that and put it under here. Believe it or not, you can still buy these bloody things. I think they're only something silly like £3 or something, £3 or £4. But I do believe my local store, Roy's, still sell these. I think that's where I got this from originally. Because this was originally mine. I can't remember. It was quite a few years ago. I gave it to my friend to use in a shed or something, or outside a shed. And it just hasn't been used for years. But yeah, I don't know. I haven't decided if I'm going to put it up there. How do you like the idea of putting it on the wall? That seems like a nice crazy idea to me. I was going to stick it under the shelf. I could stick it up the corner there under the shelf. It wouldn't be hard to do. Yeah, I like the idea of it going up here. That's that problem solved. And I've just got to find a cable. I could do it putting an inline switch on it, really, couldn't I? Yeah, I could do with an inline switch. I'll have to get one. They aren't the cheapest things to go and buy, but I will get one. I think they're like £3 or £4 for a bloody inline switch. But I can just put that in line with a bit of 2-core flex. Ooh, pardon me. Right, I'm going to get on. Because I want to get some room in here. I've got some brake levers to go in the basket. Actually, if I take that red tub outside, I can fill it with all my derailleurs. And get rid of that broken one that's in there. I'll get rid of a red container out of my bloody way. I'm not going to use the clear one because it's not strong enough. That one's a stronger one. Anything else before I turn the camera off? Yeah, I was in Sainsbury's earlier and they've got... I didn't even know Pepsi did this. It's Pepsi Max Cherry. So I got myself a couple of bottles of that as it was on offer. I found this as well. It's... service notes for some aircraft, military aircraft, I think. I found them in a bunch of car boot stuff last year. That me and my mum, in our infinite wisdom, decided to purchase. Big mistake. Never mind. So I'm going to try that on eBay. I don't know, an enthusiast might give me a couple of quid for it. I'm just thinking, what are those brake parts I can put some. I don't really want to take those down and put in the box because I might get marked, but I suppose I should. No, I need to keep a pair up here. What the? I've got super glue all up my arm. Look at this. See that? Super glue. I don't know how the hell it got up my arm. I only glued that bloody splitter to the thing out of the way. Oh well. Right. I'm going to get some stuff done. Fack. Knocked me pot of nails over. Oh well. I've got the outside cupboard sorted, so there's a few tubs gone from here at least. Yeah, I've got all my free wheels and cassettes in one tub, and I can't remember. Free wheels in one. Inner tubes I stuck in the big yellow crate. I put light brackets in the tub they were in. The inner tubes were in, I mean. I can't remember now. Oh yeah, put all my derailleurs in a new box. I've just taken all that rubbish downstairs. I'm going to do the recycle bin in a moment. the old lady at the bottom there complained about my trailer being left out back. Well, blow her window. Want no need for the snotty note left on it though, but I'll let it slide because she's going a bit in her old age, so. And she is getting on a bit, bless her, so. To get absolute, you know, to get grumpy at her wouldn't be fair. Right. Bedroom's not too bad at the minute. I think I'm gonna battle forwards in here. Do I do the recycle bin? I have got some cola bottles, haven't I? I don't know, I'll find somewhere to start. Probably picking these bloody nails up. Well, I've been a busy chappy. A lot better, isn't it? Don't want to put any of these tubs away yet because I've still got one last tub to go through. Got some recycling right there. Sort out this shit down here. Don't know what I'm going to do with this bloody thing. Actually, yes, it doesn't even work. Well, actually, I may have a play with it. What'd that do? I found a battery. It's probably a dead battery, but it's one of these. Lithium CR123A 3 volt. Stick my meter on that and we'll see if that works. And I don't know what I'm going to do with the rest of this. There's another hatch there that looks like it opens, but no freaking idea how. I think this is a film camera, I think. Pretty certain it is, anyway. Oh, it don't open there, does it? Is it open there? I'm trying to open it one-handed, which probably doesn't help. Well, I assume it opens from this end, as it looks like a hinge on there. Let me shed a bit of light on the subject, shall we? Oh, and I found another fuckload of hexagon keys as well. I'll show you those in a minute. I think I'm going to take some out and put my toolbox over at Mum's. I don't need this bloody many here. Yep, that's an old film camera. That's what I think of that. So, I'm just going to grab my meter. We'll see if there's any juice in the battery. Probably not. Probably not. What we got? .00. It's dead as a doornail, so. Beep. Clock. No wonder why I'm getting hungry. I need to find a bigger tub for bolts because I've got two tubs. I'm probably going to throw that headlamp out. Yeah, and another pile of hexagon keys and whatnot. Yay! Yeah, I'll go through them all later and keep what I want here and take some more over. I know my stepdad's got a big tub full, but I think most of them are actually imperial, which ain't a lot of use to me. And, don't know, I just prefer to have my own in my own toolbox over there. Right. Still got this thing to sort out. want a pack of artist brushes. That's what I need to get. Because it'll make life easier painting that. As far as stuff goes in here, there's a bit of floor space. That's just temporarily there. I'm going to have to move that again in a minute. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with the monitor. Ideally, I need to go through and get a bit ruthless, I think, because I've got that one there. I've got that one there. I've got the CRT over there for the old machines when I get them up and running. And I've got one in the lounge. And for some reason, I'm sure I'm missing one. Now I think three spare LCDs is all I've got. Oh yeah, I've got my big one down there, which I need to find a stand for. See, that Sony monitor came with that Sony Vaio. So I don't know. I need to get rid of at least one. I don't need all these. Or maybe get rid of two. So I've just got one that I can go to for when I'm messing around. No one that I can keep in the kitchen. That's the one that came out of the kitchen. I'm considering. Yeah, no, you're hungry. I'm hungry. I'll get us food in a minute. I think I'll get rid of the one in the lounge. That one I'll keep as a spare, just in case. And that one, as it's quite small, will be my go-to portable one, if you like. Which I might be able to stick up there somewhere out of the way. Found one of those up, which I'm going to install down there for the time being. I don't like using them. I found the lid for that, so I've just got to throw those drawers back in. I've got that cooler in there, that liquid cooler. I might put that on eBay because I'm not going to use it. But I want to do that tonight, but I've sort of got carried away cleaning and tidying and sorting things out, so that didn't happen. Oh well, always tomorrow. Right, I'm going to grab something to eat. Listen to the boy racers race around town. You get used to it. Nearly 7 years I've been here, you get used to it. Yeah, that's the USB 3 thingy I'm keeping, isn't it? Because that's the open one, I'll sell the other two. Yeah. Oh, found a lead for that light. I might fit it later and put a plug on it and make sure it all works. It's actually hiding in here. I only need a 2-core cable, so I've got this length of 2-core cable. Same colour as the light. Yeah, mount that up. Windy wall. I don't know how high I'll go with it, but I don't know what sort of bulb I'll put in it yet. I'll have to experiment, I think. Right, I'll talk to you all later. Yeah, last update for tonight, I think. The update is I've done absolutely fuck all. Yeah, I've just been sitting in front of the PC, watching a bit of Netflix, watching some YouTube. Ow. The number of weeks that cordless drill has been sitting down there, and I only just now trip over it. Right. I'd actually completely forgotten I had to come in here and just sort that lot out, and I think Nemo's a bit pissed off because I've taken most of his sleeping spots at the moment. It's probably why he hates it when I'm cleaning and moving things around, because he has nowhere peaceful, you know, to go and have 40 winks, or in a cat's case it's probably 80 winks. Seeing as all cats like to do is sleep, or at least that one does. Right. Just thinking, I'm so tempted to put Alex the Kid on, because that's the built-in game on the Master System too. Apparently it's compatible with the Sega Genesis bits and pieces. Yeah, I've just got the 16-bit Mega Drive and Master System. I don't know, what's the Master System? It's got to be 8-bit, I should think. 16-bit, I'm sure that's what the PlayStation 1 is, a 16-bit console. One of these, I'm going to do a bit of research, because I know that's the first one. You've got a headphone socket on this one. That's the volume control for it. Isn't that brilliant? I did watch a review video on YouTube earlier, and he's right, it is annoying that this doesn't have a power indicator light. I don't know why, but I like to have a power indicator as well. Even though you don't really need it, because if you've got a picture up on screen, then you know it's working anyway. But I don't know, I just like power indicators on things. It's just me. And I guess I'm not the only one. The guy at Black Records did say he had another one of these, but the cable was too badly damaged up here, so I think he said it was button number 2. It didn't work. Did I show you the games? No, I didn't, did I? I got Golden Axe. Never played, but apparently it's a good game. And Pac-Man. I actually thought there was 3 games with it. I don't know if he sold one separately. Don't bother me. I've got technically 3 games if you count the one built in, and I'm sure I can muster up some more when I'm in a mood to shop on eBay. Now, will they fit under there? Yes, they will. I'm surprised at how much these old games are going for on eBay. I mean, he's got Terminator 2 for the Master System, and he's asking 30 quid for it. Just the game. So that's the problem I've got when I buy games. If I know I'd like the game, such as GTA, then I'd be willing to spend that sort of cash, but I don't know if I'm willing to that's just the way my mind works. I'm not willing to spend large amounts of cash on a game if I'm not sure if I'm going to like playing the game or not. So I'll have a look on eBay and see what I can pick up cheap. I don't think I'd mind paying sort of like 20 quid or so for a game, because I know he's got a few Master System games up there. I suppose he got it in as one bundle and decided to include 2 games with the console and put the rest up for sale separately. Which is a smart move, because he could get more money for it that way. And of course, you know, it's a business, he's in it to make money. You know, he's got to make money, otherwise he won't eat or drink or, you know, pay his bills. Pay the shop running costs, you know, so I don't mind sticking a bit of cash in people's pockets like that. He's never done me any wrong, so I know this has got a bit of a... Ooh. Sorry about that. I obviously don't like spotlights, this camera, because that went really, really blurry. Right. I'm going to drag my washing basket out of the way. Drag that monitor out of the way. And I've got to crawl under there. In fact, I'll just pull this out of the way. I've actually put the feet on the bottom as well, so it actually slides a lot better. What the hell is that plug for? And I've unplugged the extension cable there. What I wanted to do... Where's my torch? Where's my, I had the flipping thing a minute ago. Oh, there it is. That's the light I was looking for. We'll go down here into the dark depths together. Light. There we go. Right. Now, what I want to do when I get down on the floor myself is sort these plugs out. Now I got to think. I don't like using that. One of those plugs is a lamp. See, that's a big adapter. I'm not sure. If I'm going to get two large adapters side by side. This is why, when I get some cash, I'm going to buy a new double socket and box and put it on the wall right beside this one. Or, if I don't put it right beside this one, I could put it further. Now it'd be easier to get it right beside this one, thinking about it. Otherwise I've got to try and get behind that bloody leg and yeah, it'd be too much of an arse-ache. Right. So, I'm going to try and get under here without getting my head in the light. Unplug. Unplug. That's for the that one is for the light in the cupboard in the hallway. Cobwebs under here already. Fucking spiders. Piss off. Go make cobwebs elsewhere. That one's the PS2, this one. So, I've got... We've got Mega Drive, TV, PS1. Will this thing go in here? That's the question. Yeah, it will. Good. So now I want this up the top here. In the top of that. Actually, I've just realised I'm not sure I want to do it that way. Because I don't want these adapters running 24/7, so I'll change that and plug that one in there and plug this one with the PCs in there. That's less weight hanging on that block adapter as well. That's just a temporary fix until I can get an extra socket under here. And I may even hang that outlet on the wall. Possibly. And just to get it and put it up there like that. Although I don't know if I can because the cable isn't long enough because I shortened it. Right, I've got an itchy leg. Right, that's the TV one. Right. Switch that one off. Oh. And I'll slide my television all the way up. And actually, the back of the TV is leaning on that adapter brick thing, and well, that'll stop it falling out the socket at least. So there's no risk of an arc there, is the extension socket is turned off here. I've got a switch on that as well. Bit of Lego. Oh, dearie me. Right. Pardon. That's a hell of a lot better with the feet on. I'm just going to leave that gap there just as like a service gap. Just in case I need to get up there. Alright. Now what I'm going to do. Give you a front view. Look. Might as well. I've got to stuff all these drawers back in. Just gonna piss off the cat as well. put the heaviest ones at the bottom here. All the TV and whatnot cables. Next ones, PC cables. I do apologise for the shaking. Oh, hang on. That's better. Either my cabinet is on the piss or the architrave for the cabinet is one or the other. Actually, considering that wall isn't square with the back wall over there, then I wouldn't be surprised if it's actually the wall. My bike lights I got for Christmas. I had one of these fitted to the GT and I let it go on there. I couldn't be bothered to take it off. I didn't see the point. That was the point when I got a box full. Right. So that's all done and back up the corner. I've put some of those laptops away in the laptop cupboard. Put the JVC camera up here. I put all these laptops on display and then I went and piled a load of shit on top of the laptops. Oh, excuse me. Have you noticed that ever since I've laid off the lactose, I'm not farting on camera nowhere near as much? And by lactose, yeah. I've sort of gone lacto-free, but where I can, I've gone lactose-free. Well, actually, the other thing I've laid off of as well is the baked beans. Because I used to have those for breakfast every morning. Ah. I want to keep that because it's for a Dell PC. An empty blue... Oh, that's the other thing I did. I've put all my... laptop adapters in the drawer, so I've got them all in a drawer now. And these two halogen bulbs, I'll go in my odds and sods drawer. So from that, what's this? Screwdriver bits can go in the cupboard in the hallway. This is the light I was referring to. Plugged it in the bedroom. There was already a hole in the wall down there, so I just ran that extension cord through. But I think, if I can find it... Oh, there isn't. Yes, there is. There's a little hole right up in that corner. Right up there. And then there's one... there. And there's also one in the wall where my outside cupboard is. I'm guessing that the previous tenant had a fridge. Actually, I do recall my neighbour saying that he had a fridge freezer out in the outside cupboard. See, there's only a light in the outside cupboard. There's no power outlet or anything, so I'm guessing he ran his own power cable out there to run it. And to be honest, if it wasn't so full of shit, I'd have done the same thing. Although, it looks like Victory has bunged up the hole above the front door here. Why do we call it a front door? I've only got the one fucking door. But that thing is annoying as hell. And a number of times I've actually been tempted to come along and actually take... Where's that all bent? I don't recall doing that. Benton. Anyway, yeah, the number of times I've actually been tempted to come along and take that off the frickin' door. Because when you're trying to go in and out of this, all you've got is that door closure swinging the fucking door shut on you. It does tend to get on your titties. Actually, I'm going to turn this one on. I actually use this one quite a lot. I think what would look nice if I got a coloured LED bulb to put in there. That would look nice, wouldn't it? A nice colour in there. In fact, I have got some. They're old, but... and they're dim as hell, but... I don't know. I'll dig one out and try one. It's under the bed and I'm not digging it out tonight. Oh, and this is a motorbike headlight. It has got three wires. It's got the ground and it's got the high beam, low beam. But everything that sort of puzzled me is there's no parking light in this one. Unless it's designed so you had a separate parking light mounted on the bike. I don't know. I suppose that's what you would have to do. So that's going on eBay. I've still got this to try. I've got that to put on eBay tomorrow. I've got both of those to put on eBay. And I'm going to clear all the shit off of this. I never did come back to see if I've managed to loosen off this seat post. It's had long enough to soak. Is that 13 or a 14? That is a 14. I'm definitely not short of a screw now. I've still got my other tub of screws as well. I've topped that up as well. But I'm actually surprised. I mean, when I first moved in here, that tub of screws of mine in the hallway cupboard was chock full. I've actually used quite a few of them. Not just in here, but at mum's and whatnot. So I do like to keep an assortment of screws. Yeah, there's the other tub. They're absolutely chock full. Yeah, the other thing I was going to do tonight, which I'm not going to go into anymore, was just take all the electrical items out of that tub and stick in the electrical box under the bed. Well, pretty much once I've got that box done and that one done, that's everything I got from my friend's sword. Absolutely everything. Then maybe I can get back to tinkering with some Lego. That'd be nice. Right. It's actually very, very tempting to keep this one. And like I said, stick it over at mum's. But if I can't get that seat to go down, we're stuffed. Should we have a quick look while I'm over here? I need a 14mm spanner, don't I? What's that one? That's a 13. Typical. No. No. Bear with me 2 seconds. What's this one? No. I know damn well I've got a double-ended spanner with a 15mm and a 14mm on it. And do you think I can find the fucking thing? Ah, I think I found it. No. That's the Imperial one. That's not the one I wanted. Oh, hell. Who's this one? It's another friggin' 13. What's that one? That's an 11. Really? Ah, found one. I found one. Would you believe it? After all that, that is a 13. Bitch. Yep, and I was so certain nope. Seat still once done. I may have to get my pipe wrench on this and an hammer. Although, I'm not putting a hammer on it tonight. I don't think my neighbour below me would appreciate me doing that at nearly 10:30 at night. I think that is about as tight as I can get that seat. So, no, in good turn. That's gonna need a bit of gentle persuasion tomorrow, I think. Whew. Yeah, that booger ain't coming off. Well, that's the Packard Bell adaptor. Yeah, see what else I can find to chuck on eBay. I think that battery can go in a bin. I'm pretty certain I don't have a Parkside drill. I think I used to, but not anymore. I got the other battery to charge up for the Bosch. Oh, that was the other thing, going back to the cupboard, because I forgot. When he was having a clean out, I actually found... Is it that one? Nope. I've got a base for the blue drill right over the back there. The New Tool brand, which is just a cheap generic shit brand. But I used my own charger or adapter for the base, because my friend gave it to me, there was no adapter for it. What have I got a DVD front in here? It's not meant to be in here. But anyway, I've got the proper... Oh, new power, not new tool. Got the proper new power adapter for the base. The base is in here somewhere. Oh, I forgot I had that spotlight. Oh, that's for the old JCB drill, which I've decided not to do anything with. It's not worth it. So, that's something... I was going to say, that can go in the bin. I'm taking the plug off first. I might actually take that apart. I've had it apart once to put the lead on, so I may take that apart again. Completely forgot that was stored in here. What's this one? I've forgotten what drill that one goes to. I'm just wondering. Ooh, this one fit? Kinda. Kinda, sort of. Bloody stand. Are these still charged? Yeah, that one is. No, the new power one don't sound very healthy, does it? Well, I know the base for the new power one is in here somewhere. Or about the flat somewhere, if it's not in here. I'm going to put some screws in the wall to hang those on. Or better yet, I could stick a screw up there. You know, it's not like I'm short of screws. Right. It's disappeared. Oh well, I know the base is around here somewhere. Right, I'm going to call it quits for the video and get this up. So, thanks a lot for watching. And zoomed in again, I must have hit the zoom button. I actually don't have a clue what I'm doing tomorrow. Mum was going to call me tonight, but I'm still waiting. Because she did toy with the idea of picking me up in the morning, because she's got work in the afternoon, and then bringing me back in the afternoon as normal, but I don't know if she's going to do that. I haven't heard. Oh well. Anyway, thanks for watching. And I'll talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.